Government of Karnataka, Sri Gaurav Gupta, Principal Secretary, Industry and Commerce, Government of Karnataka, my other friends in the dais, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. It gives me great pleasure to welcome you all to this August occasion of Invest Karnataka Road, organized by Government of Karnataka in Hyderabad. Government of Karnataka, under the leadership of Shri Hyderabad, Honorable Chief Minister, have taken series of measures to bring the next level of industrial and economic growth in the state. One of the shining examples is the decision to create an industrial hub in Pune and Dharwad region, where cluster-based industrial corridors are being set up. This undoubtedly is going to transform the economic climate of the region, and the region has tremendous potential for growth with its vast resources of land and labor in proximity to the states like Maharashtra, Pradesh, and Telangana. The FMCG cluster, the defense cluster, the aerospace cluster, and the e-vehicle cluster, exclusive manufacturing zones, are some of the important manufacturing hubs that will provide ample opportunities for investors and also for the consumers. Moreover, the liberal approach of the state government with a proactive incentive scheme and also fast clearances would help to complete the project within the stipulated design time. We, the industrial fraternity, is really excited about the prospects that feel that the momentum that has been created by the government would unleash the next phase of growth in Karnataka state. Historically, the state of Karnataka is a place of technology-based manufacturing where information technology, biotechnology, defense and aerospace, automotive industry, etc. have proliferated. Vast pool of manpower and the technology-based production, spirit and innovation, and that example that entrepreneurial enthusiasm, the backbone of the industrial development of the state in the past couple of decades. The next wave of technology revolution is happening through the emergence of large number of startups in the state. You know that the Bangalore is the startup capital of the country, and innovation is the key of manufacturing in this digital era. Smart manufacturing will decide the success of the future. Karnataka has already set up the basic growth fundamentals through heightened focus on innovation, and government sustained support for innovation is well known for us and for the country. Friends, both of our states, Karnataka and Telangana, have exemplary entrepreneurial communities. The spirit of partnership between the states can help create a strong regional economy where economies of scale can work for the benefit of the people of the region. Mutual cooperation can help the industry to create more jobs in the region and thereby create a large market for the products and services what both of us can offer in this region. Undoubtedly, the future belongs to the region, and the vision of the government is to fulfill the dreams of the comprehensive development of the region through effective collaboration and cooperation of the industrialists and the government. We are all eager to hear from both the ministers, one who has come from Delhi, the Union Minister, and our own Industry Minister from Karnataka. They are here to share their dynamic vision and attractive measures. And our own Principal Secretary, Gaurav Gupta, is the person who is going to hold your hand if you come to Karnataka and invest in Karnataka. He is also here. And together, I'm sure, as industrialists, we can do wonders by going to India, investing in Karnataka, and creating the jobs for the towns of the people. And that is good for the industry and good for the citizens and also good for the consumer. On behalf of the FICCI, which is the industrial fraternity, I would like to once again extend a warm welcome to all of you in this important roadshow. Last but the least, you know that Karnataka and Telangana share a very, very warm relationship. Most of the Udupi hotels are in Telangana and Andhra Pradesh, and we have more of Nagarjuna's and we have more of Andhra food available in Bangalore. So if you come to Karnataka, one thing will guarantee you, you will get the home food in every district headquarters, because the most sought after cuisine for lunch in Karnataka is Andhra meats. So it is already ready for you, you will not miss your home. So please come to Karnataka, invest in Karnataka, and let us grow together for the betterment of the region. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to invite Shri Gaurav Gupta, Principal Secretary, Industry and Commerce, Government of Karnataka, to take us through the presentation on investment opportunities in Karnataka. Ladies and gentlemen, talking about him, Shri Gaurav Gupta is an officer of Indian Administrative Service of the 1990 batch. He has experience of 25 years in field of commerce and industries, infrastructure, power, urban development, and transportation. Presently, he is serving as Principal Secretary, Commerce and Industries Department, Government of Karnataka. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together and welcome him with a huge round of applause.
A very good evening. Honorable Minister, Honorable Union Minister for Parliamentary Affairs, Sports and Mines, Shettar, Joshi. Honorable Minister for Large and Medium Scale Industries, Government of Karnataka, Shri Jagadish. We have industry representatives on the dais as always, and we have Mr. Ullas, Chairman of FICCI Karnataka, who has come here joined from Bangalore. We have Mr. Murali, Reddy, Co-Chair of FICCI Telangana State. Mr. Sudhakar, Gande, Vice Chairman of Axiscades Engineering Solution, and Anil, Muniswamy, and Managing Director of Slate Technologies. Welcome to you all, sir. It indeed is a privilege for us to welcome all the delegates who have come here, various organizations, entrepreneurs, business leaders, and association, and we thank you for your valuable presence this evening. Honorable Union Minister, Mr. Joshi has been a leader who has been driving path-breaking initiatives at the national level, and also I would say, venture to say that at the level of promoting North Karnataka also he has been an exemplary presence. We are really grateful, sir, for your presence here. And Mr. Jagadish, Honorable Minister, also has been a pillar of strength in our request for investment promotion. Today we have had one-to-one interactions with several of the industries here. We have also gone to several industries, to their offices also, to the factories also. Government of Karnataka is indeed committed to accelerate industrial development and create employment opportunities for the youth of the state. And in that context, the Government of Karnataka is hosting the Invest Karnataka Global Investors Meet on 3rd to 5th November 2020 in Bangalore, which will herald a visionary approach to identify and capitalize on the opportunities under the Make in Karnataka campaign. And a part of that, we are also hosting a program in Make in Karnataka public conference, and that is on 14th of February, which is shortly some time away. And let me guide you through the presentation about the opportunities that are there in Karnataka. Karnataka has been not only an IT hub. Very often people do the mistake of saying, look here, Karnataka is for IT. Karnataka is for IT, but Karnataka is for several other things as well. So Karnataka is aerospace hub. Almost 65% of India's aerospace investments and turnover, design, and also the manufacturing of aerospace sector takes place in Karnataka. 60% of India's biotech happens in Karnataka. The leading brand of biopharm industry, there's the Dr. Kirishma Shaw, is in Karnataka. She has been the guiding spirit. Yes, we are one of the largest in exports, export of software, but software is not just a plain vanilla software. It is also very often engineering, research and design. And 44% of R&D centers in India are in Karnataka. We are the largest producer of coffee and number of other agricultural produce. There are breweries, there are vineyards, etc., etc., gherkins, and number of others. It is also India's startup capital. Entrepreneurship is in the blood of Karnataka. A lot of new enterprises have started. Karnataka has a GDP, state GDP of $250 billion. It is almost comparable to any other big country, almost the size of Thailand, and a comparable economy also, and growing at 9.6% per annum. We are first, as mentioned, in a number of things, but most importantly, Karnataka has been a very open economy, very well linked to the global ecosystem, part of the global supply chain. Whether it is IT, whether it is aerospace, whether it is biotech, our people are basically integrally linked to the world. And that is what provides the kind of resilience. And even if there is a downturn or a slowdown or something like that, so long as the international growth is there, so lot of things happen. I recall Anil Stanley, the Airbus India head, saying that people talk about recession. He says, what recession? What slowdown? There is hardly, there is a rush for talent. And we want more and more talent. We want to grow further. So Karnataka has a very robust ecosystem. Not only we have these sectors, but also in the key sectors of education, healthcare, hospitals, Karnataka has been leading. And we have infrastructure in terms of highways. We have two industrial corridors, Mumbai-Bangalore Economic Corridor, and also Chennai-Bangalore Industrial Corridor. And these corridors are basically, we are establishing hubs, industrial hubs around that. And Tumkur is identified as one of the leading hubs, which will be almost 12,000 acres of land, 50 square kilometers of land, which will be developed into a major industrial township, greenfield industrial township in the days to come with the support of Government of India. Education-wise, I am Bangalore to Indian Institute of Science. These are absolutely premier institutes, and also National Law School, University of India, and several other institutions. And these are all there because of the excellence that has prevailed in this sector. Private enterprises also come in. Manipal was perhaps the first one of the universities that came up. In terms of skilling infrastructure, we also have a number of IDIs, polytechnics, engineering colleges, and various schemes from Government of India and state government to take care of training of the people, skilling and reskilling of the people to make them equipped for the new challenges. From what we interact with the industry, every 8 to 10 years, there is a skilling and reskilling which happens. And that is what makes the manpower ready for new and new initiatives. So this is again about the knowledge hub, biotechnology, R&D centers, etc. I have covered some of this. I think we can go to the next one. This is about the industrial policy. Now, industrial policy, and there have been not only one policy, there are almost 20 policies in Karnataka, depending on the sectors. So pharma, we have a separate policy. We have a separate policy for aerospace. We have a separate policy for electric vehicle and textile policy, etc. And these are basically done with the consultation of the industry. The industry tells us as to what is required for the growth of the for the industry, and we tailor make policy. The state cabinet has been very, very responsive. The industry ministers have been very responsive. They respond to the needs of the industry, the articulate demands of the industry, and then it takes up. As in terms of ease of doing business, again, lot of initiatives have been taken up. Karnataka was the first one to set up the single window agency and time-bound grievance handling, regular consultation with the industry, and online application and approval. So if you want to apply in Karnataka to get approvals, you have to apply online. And this investment memorandum can be applied in Invest Karnataka. You can just Google search and you can apply there. Not only application, but also downstream approvals also get done to the same portal. In terms of lifestyle and entertainment, I need not say anything. I'm sure that you are very conversant with it. Karnataka has a rich culture, rich people, expats living from all around the world, number of cuisines, festivals, etc. Focus sectors are these nine focus sectors that are listed out. Machine tools is one of the major sectors which we are taking up. And Tumkur, we are setting up the first of the machine tool park in support of the Government of India. And this integrated machine tool park will take care of more and more investments in this sector, in the capital goods segment of the industry. We also have precision engineering in Belgavi and also in Mangalore, and not only in Bangalore. And also manufacturing 4.0 being taken up by a number of people across the industry chain. I've seen in Mysore, in other smaller places also, industry 4.0 being adopted. Innovation and startups, more than 10,000 startups now in Karnataka on various facets, healthcare, maybe education, maybe agriculture, and number of others. And the startup policy, Karnataka was the first of the policies which was taken up. And there's a lot of support system which has been created over the years to see that how startups can flourish. Whatever they need is, whether it is funds, whether it is seed fund, whether it is venture fund, or whether it is infrastructure support in terms of incubation center, all of that has been taken up. Now, this has led to the kind of growth. Last year, $13.5 million came into investments into startups, and 50% of that came in Bangalore. So that is the kind of power of startups, which is leading to a lot of inward investments into the state. Aerospace and defense, a lot of opportunities, whether we call it Airbus or Boeing or a number of others, they are all present there. Defense in the center, a lot of DRDO labs, BEM, BHEL, BML, etc., and a number of other incident units, etc., that have emerged. Farm and medical devices, they are also, we are there, and we are collaborating now. One of the thrust areas of why we came to Hyderabad is to first borrow from some of your inspiring ideas and to see how this can flourish further. Agri and food processing is again a major sector. We are looking at agri exports, and agri exports is being supported by a lot of testing and certification centers. And not only about one commodity, there are several agro-climatic zones and several commodities that are there, and there's a lot of activity going on in this field. Textiles and apparel, again, man-made fibers or natural fibers. Karnataka is one of the leading ones in terms of garments capital. Shahi exports of more than 45 units in terms of producing of garments in Karnataka. And we are looking at more garment parks also. Karnataka has a very vibrant textile